Over here, I have a blind. It's installed on a face brick wall. Now, one of the problems with face brick walls is that they are uneven. So in this video, I'll demonstrate how to install on an uneven face brick wall. Now, since there's a variety of different types of blinds, I'm going to demonstrate with two different blinds. So I'm first going to show this one, and then I'll show this one. I'm going to quickly zoom in to show you the different mechanisms. Maybe the mechanism that I show is the one that you have. Now, this is one of the mechanisms. It has these two brackets on either side of the blind, which need to be installed. And then it's got this cover, which you would slide on. Now, in this case, I'm disassembling it. And there is the blind. What happens is it slides in there. So this is holding up the blind. So on the far end, there is the other bracket, which is the same as the one I've just shown. However, because this is plastic, the blind needs a support in the middle. So there is an additional bracket that goes there in the middle. And this is where it gets technical, as the surface of the brick is different across all three of these points. So if I pull the blind down a bit here, you can see there's a space between where my finger is and the blind. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to remove this and just quickly show you a sneak peek at what I did in order to solve this problem. Notice that the bracket is standing off the wall by about 15 millimeters. Now, the reason it stands off the wall is because it has to align into that hole, and then this has to be at the same level as the brackets on the side. So this level and this level must be in the same plane, otherwise the blind would be deformed and warped. Right, now let's have a look at the other system. Now, on this blind, it comes with a set of metal brackets. These brackets can be installed along the path of the blind. Now, this is what the bracket looks like. And what happens is I need to have this lever open. I slide it underneath there. It leans on the back. This would be mounted into the wall. And in order to hold this in place, I now close the lever. And the lever is putting pressure on the top there, and now the bracket is held in place. So for this type of blind, I just need to align these, but the purpose of the video is to show how to do that with an uneven brick wall. So whether you have this type of system or the system where you need to install the bracket on the side and then the bracket in the middle, I'm going to demonstrate how to put both of these on the wall. I'm going to start with the one where the bracket sits on the sides, and we slide the blind into the bracket and then fasten the middle bracket into the middle of the blind. Right, so the installation is going to be here across these two windows. I want to block out these two windows. So I'm aiming to duplicate what I already have here. Now, the blind is long enough to go there to there. Now, the problem is this brick is higher than that brick and that brick. That means I'm going to have to put a spacer between the brick and the bracket, and here between the brick and the bracket. So the first thing I need to do is measure the blind. Right, so I have the blind here, and as I'm showing that, it's going to wobble. But I'm still going to take the measurements on the left and the right. The bracket works as follows. It can be positioned in many ways depending on how you install this. If you're installing it on the inside of the window, then I would be using those two screws. What's most important is that the mouth, the opening part here, faces out so that I can get the blind in there. The blind needs to be slotted in order to hang it. And then I slide this cover, which holds this in place. So what I need to do now is mark off the holes. Now, in this case, I'm mounting it on a wall. Now, inside there are four holes. Now, because I'm drilling into a brick, I'm only going to drill two holes. Two holes with two screws is enough for this size blind. If you're drilling into wood, well then yes, you could easily use the four holes, but two screws for masonry is sufficient. In my case, I'm just going to mark off a top and a bottom hole. Now, this step is probably the most difficult step. It's easier if you have two people. I'm one person here, so I'm going to just do this on my own. Now, the first thing I need to do is make sure that it's in the middle. So I do not want to be drilling into the edge of a brick. For example, if I put this bracket right on the edge here, when I drill, it's just going to split the brick. So the bracket needs to be at least over there. Now, because I'm matching it to another blind, I would need a spirit level to make sure that the new blind, the one next to it, will be at the same level. So I'll also have to check that. Now, I've determined that that side and this side are correctly placed in terms of not being too close to the edge of the brick. So in terms of the position, I'm now fine. What I need to do now is mark off the left-hand side and then the right-hand side. Now that I've determined the level there and the position here, I just need to mark off this bracket. I won't be able to mark off the holes inside there. All I'm going to do is outline the outside of this bracket. So I'm going to push it against the wall, flush, making sure that that alignment is correct because I'm matching it to another blind, but also that the blind is in the correct position, horizontal to the floor. So this has to go up just a little bit. And now what I'm doing is I'm just taking my correction fluid and I'm marking off the edge of the bracket. And it doesn't even have to be that perfect. Right, there's my Picasso. So all I do is I put this back here. Remember that I marked around it. So this is going to sit on the outline, the template. And I can quickly just do a level check to the blind next door so that they will be at the same level. And now all I'm going to do is I'm going to make a dot where I'm going to be drilling. So there's my two dots. And now all I need to do is drill those two holes. Now the plugs that came with the unit are 6mm. Because this is masonry, I'm not going to drill a 6mm hole right away. I'm going to drill a pilot hole with a smaller bit because the minute I put the bit here, it tends to move as I start drilling. So it's much easier to control a smaller bit, and that's why I'm drilling the pilot hole first. Now I can go ahead and drill the 6mm holes because the nylon plug I'm using is 6mm. Now I can insert the nylon plugs. Now I just take some alcohol and remove the correction fluid, my markings. Right, now I'm going to screw in the bracket. And unfortunately, this thing is sitting a little bit skew, and even with the pilot hole, because it's masonry, the drill bit happened to move a little bit. And if you have this problem, it's not a big issue. All I need to do is just drill the hole a little bit wider. So because it's not quite aligned, I'm just drilling these two little plastic holes a little bit wider. And that's not a problem because there's lots of space inside there, and I can also just add a washer if need be. So for example, I can just add a washer there so the head won't go through the hole, and that will provide perfect alignment now. Right, I've tightened this, but I know that this is too close to the wall. I'm still going to make it stand off. But the reason I've tightened it is if I don't tighten it and I bring the blind to level it up, if it's not tightened, it will lean a little bit and I won't get an exact level. So I've just tightened it for now, and I'm going to measure the other side now. Right, so I'm inserting that into the fasten side, and now I'm going to take the other side. There's the bracket. And you might even notice that it's popping out of there because the bracket is close to the wall, but this brick in the middle is pushing it out. That we will solve now. What I want to do now is make sure that it's level. And one of the problems with face brick is you might find that the level is not exactly aligned to the brick level. So you sometimes have to make a decision whether you want to go with the spirit level or the brick line. Right, now I don't push the bracket very firmly inside. It's fine if there's a little gap of 2mm or so. That also makes it easier if your drilling isn't exactly accurate, because if this is drilled too much to the side, you won't be able to get the bracket in if it's too close. It means you might have to cut this a bit. Right, so I'm just leaving a 2mm gap on the side here, and I'm drawing around the bracket. Right, following the same procedure I did before, I'm just marking off the two holes. Right, I'm first drilling the pilot holes. And now the main hole. And now I'll put in the plugs. Clean my markings off. And screw screws. This one is straight. I managed to drill it perfectly first time. Right, now I can insert my blind. Right, so I've inserted the blind. Now the next step is to align this middle piece. So this middle piece goes underneath and round. So what I need to do is insert it in here now. There's that middle piece, but now I need to mark it off here. So I'm just taking my correction fluid and just marking off where this middle piece would be. Now, if your blind is a very big blind, a very wide blind, this might have sagged already. So at this point, you might need the spirit level before you do your marking, just to make sure that where you're marking it is still level. In my case, the blind isn't very big, so it's not sagging much. Right, so now all I need to do is drill that hole. So I can remove this now. Exactly where I marked it, I can now make my dot here. Now you can drill more than one hole if you want to. Mine is a small little blind. I'm actually only going to drill one hole. Now I'm screwing this in as final because this brick is the higher brick. So if I bring the blind back, there, it is correct. It is now resting on this bracket. Right, so this is holding it nice and firmly. The problem is the brackets on the sides need to be lifted from the wall. So this is where we need to determine how much the brackets need to be lifted from the wall. So what I do is I put it into a position which is at rest. What I mean is there's nothing forcing it in there. There's nothing forcing it in on the other side. I quickly make sure it's straight, perfectly straight. And now what I do is I measure how far the bracket needs to move away from the wall. Right, so there's the bracket, and this is supposed to be in there like that, but it's sitting like that. So what I need to do, I need to unscrew the screws. I've only removed the left-hand side bracket. Now I make sure that this is at rest. What I mean by that is it shouldn't be pushed in this side and then it's out that side, because then it's skew. And it shouldn't be pushed against that wall, because then this side is coming out. And the reason why it will do that is because it's raised in the middle. That's why it's wobbling like this. Yours might be just that side raised, or maybe two sides are raised and one is in, but you can apply the same logic that I'm following now. So I've got it flush against the middle portion here. Right, so now what I do is I see how much this bracket needs to move. That amount there, that's what I'm going to measure. Yeah, so you can just measure how much it's standing away from the wall. So in this case, it's 11 millimeters. So what I can do is I can use a nut as a spacer. It's 9.7 millimeters. That's pretty close. You could also use washers and stack them. Now at this juncture, I can't use the original screw, because if I use the original screw plus the nut, now it's way too short. So I'm now going to use a longer screw. And note the nut in between the brick and the bracket. And since there's two screws, I need two nuts. Now, if you don't want to see the nut at the bottom there, you can just tap it away. Right, so this is tight. Now I'm going to put the blind back on. This section here and this section are in the same plane. Now I just have to do the same on the other side. Right, following the same method, I make sure it is flush here. And as soon as I do that, it lifts off the wall there, and I just measure the gap between the wall and the bracket. All right, it happens to be the same. It's also 11 millimeters, so I'm going to use the same nuts that I used before. Right, so there are the nuts spacing it from the wall. Right, having a side view, I'm showing that the blind is completely straight. There's no warping of that plastic frame, because now it is mounted correctly. So all I need to do is close the little covers on each side to hold it in place. Right, so this is stable. It can't move out of the sides because it's locked in place. These are pretty stable. The nuts make it firm. The little bracket in the middle there, that's holding this in place. And there on that side, it is all mounted. Now I just put the handle on here and I can adjust the blinds. Right, there are the two blinds installed on the completely uneven brick wall. Now I'll demonstrate how to install the other type of blind. Right, now for this installation, I've got the steel blinds and I want it to be like that. So I have the same problem with uneven bricks. So the first thing I'm going to do is first determine where each bracket goes. Right, so because I'm covering these three windows, I want to be at the middle over here. So this is the midpoint of the blinds, so I know that I'm going to be somewhere there. Now I can maneuver these brackets, because here's one bracket over here and then there's one over there. Now I can actually select where I want the brackets, because I can maneuver them. Remember I showed in the beginning of the video. So all I need to do now is to determine that the bracket must not be on an edge of a brick, because if I drill on the edge of a brick, it's just going to break the brick. So over here, I've checked it. I've moved the bracket up a bit. It's fine. That one is fine, and the far one on the right, which is out of the picture, is also fine. Now I just need to make sure that the bracket is straight and high enough. Right, now from a top view, I can take my marking pen and mark the top of the bracket. So I'm just drawing a line above the bracket. It might be easier to use a pencil. Right, so I'm just marking it with a pencil. Now I take my spirit level and I just confirm that those pencil lines are straight. Yes, straight, and I do the other side, straight. Right, now recall that the bracket is not necessarily fixed to a certain position. So I can shift the bracket left or right. So it's not that critical if I drilled a little bit there or a little bit there. Most important is that the line is correct. So I'm not going to drill above the line or below the line. When I had the brackets on the blinds, there is a mechanism running in the middle of that blind. So just be aware that you can't suddenly just decide to put it there. You might be interfering with the mechanism a little bit. So yes, I can shift it maybe a centimeter or two. Right. So I'm going to just put it over there and just make a dot where I'm going to drill my holes. And I do this three times now. Now, in this case, all the bricks are recessed. That means that the bricks on the sides of where I'm drilling the holes are higher. So all that it means is that I have to put spacers on each one of these brackets. So what I'm doing now is I'm just measuring how much of the spacing I need. Right, so this one is 2 millimeters. 8. Right, so the bracket in the middle is just 2 millimeters. So there's just 2 washers there, and I can fasten this one down. Right, the one on this side over here is 8 millimeters. So I've got an 8 millimeter thick nut. And the one on the far side here was 13. So I've got a 10 millimeter nut plus 2 washers. These are slightly fatter washers, and I can always add more if it's wrong. Right, now what I do is I take my spirit level and I just check that the brackets are horizontal. Yes, correct. And between these two, yes. Now make sure the screws are tight and this is not going anywhere. Now the beauty of this system is that I can now slot it in one go. There's a lip here running along the top, and there's 2 fingers on each one of these brackets which I need to hook into the lip. Make sure this lever is open. So I've managed to get them all in. Now I let the blind go against the wall. Now these levers have to be open. If they're not open, this does not move in there, because if it's like that, it's blocked by the lever. Levers are all open now, and then I twist it in, and then I use the lever to hold it in place. 1, 2, and 3. So this blind is actually already in place and it's strong. Now I just need to fit the handle. There we go. And then lastly, if you don't want the blinds to wobble in the wind, all you do is you install this little clip that goes at the bottom. It has to be screwed into the wall, and then you can clip the blind into here and it remains tight against the wall. It won't blow in the wind. Same as for the other blind. Thanks for watching, and cheers.